So today we are gathered here for the signing ceremony of the multi-institutional MOU for DUNE, our flagship science program. And this is a historical and a significant moment for the program, for the laboratory. So we will begin today's event with welcome remarks from our laboratory director, Leah.
Hello, everyone, and good afternoon. So as I was thinking this morning about my remarks, I realized that today's signing of the DUNE MOU is actually a watershed moment. DUNE is the first internationally conceived, constructed, and operated mega science experiment hosted by the Department of Energy on U.S. soil. And the signing of today's MOU embodies just that. Partners from around the world are here today to formalize your country's commitment to constructing the best-in-class neutrino experiment. I extend my sincere gratitude to all of you for your contributions, commitment, and excellence. In fact, every facet of the experiment is powered by international collaborations and partnerships. The DUNE collaboration itself, which represents over 1,400 scientists and engineers from over 200 research institutions around the world, PIP2 that powers DUNE, and LBNF, the facility that houses DUNE and reaches from Fermilab to Leeds, South Dakota. All of them are international. The scientific results that will emerge from DUNE have the potential to revolutionize particle physics forever. I dream of the moment when we all get together to celebrate major discoveries from DUNE. And I know this moment will come with the commitment and dedication of the worldwide community of scientists and engineers. On behalf of Fermilab, I express my heartfelt appreciation to the countries who will officially sign the MOU shortly for doing your part to help accomplish this massive scientific venture and change the understanding of our world around us. Today's signing of the DUNE MOU is also a culmination of many years of hard work by many individuals. So thank you all very much.
Thank you, Leah. So now we'll begin the signing of the multi-institutional MOU, and I would like to invite the representatives from UK, Italy, France, Brazil, Switzerland, and Fermilab leader to join us here. Today we will also be signing this agreement with CERN and with Canada, two institutions, CFI and NSERC. Since those representatives will not be here with us in person, we are facilitating the counter signatures via mail with them. And we will be coordinating signatures with the other countries in the near future. Okay. Okay, thank you all for signing. So now we'd like to welcome Office of High Energy Physics Associate Director Gina Remica to share a few words.
Well, thank you, and thank you all for coming. I just have a few remarks. The one thing that occurred to me that I wanted to share is an observation that we sign these agreements and, you know, everybody's like, okay, now we know that we're good to go. But I just want to make the observation that every one of these partners has already delivered. They weren't waiting for an MOU to sign before contributing to the experiment and to the project. And so we're very, very grateful for the trust that they have put in us in able to be able to deliver this project. So again, thank you very, very much.
Thank you, Gina. Now we'd like to receive brief remarks from our international partners.
I'm really pleased to be able to sign this MOU on behalf of the UK. It really does express our long-term commitment to this project a long-term commitment to our partnership with Fermilab, the US Department of Energy, and all of my other colleagues from around the globe who are participating in this project. The reason we're here, of course, is not just to sign a piece of paper, it's that we're deeply committed to actually delivering what will be one of the great experiments in the world, one of the greatest experiments that we've ever conceived. And as I say, today really just reaffirms our long-term commitment. I'm really excited to see what's going to happen over the next 10 years and actually when we start to do the science and start to learn more about the universe. Ultimately, that's what we're doing.
It's indeed a great pleasure, both on behalf of the INFN, of my country, of the people that work in this very important project. But we are, as Mark said, fully committed to this project. It's a key scientific project in the international scenario. It is the future of neutrino physics, certainly in the United States, but all over the world. Of course, it's a competing experiment. This is good. We have to do it well, to do it fast, to do it as soon as possible to get to the science that, as was said by many, it's very exciting, it's very important. INFN is investing in this project more than any other project currently undertaken, very comparable, maybe even slightly more than what we do at CERN. So it's really a keen effort. It's, as Mark said, we are not just to sign a piece of paper, we are to restate again the importance of this collaboration, the importance of this project. And I am also very keen to see the results of the big science that very likely will come out.
So let me start by saying that in France, we are very happy and actually very proud to be part of this, with all of you to be part of this very exciting project. Actually, I should say projects, because we've heard today and yesterday, I mean, a lot of progress is being made. Everything is progressing nicely, and it's very very impressive to see how things are moving forward. So we look forward for having this experiment in neutrino physics being at the forefront of particle physics. Speaking of neutrino physics, actually, I think it's probably important to remind ourselves why we want to put so much effort into neutrino physics. And I guess the best answer to that, in my mind, is that actually neutrinos are the maybe the only clue or positive clue of new physics beyond the standard model of particle physics. And that's something which is unusual. We know that the standard model is not complete. We know that things are missing, like dark matter. So it doesn't describe the physical reality yet. But what is very different with neutrinos is neutrino exists, they have a mass, and this is not at all described in the standard model of particles. The Higgs particle doesn't give mass to neutrinos. So we really need to understand this puzzle and find new physics beyond the standard model. That's what's important with neutrino physics. Let me end by saying again, I mean, that in France we are committed to contribute to this project. It's a big investment for us as well, and it's a big investment, and it's actually our first priority in this field of research. And we are really happy to be here today, and personally I'm very happy to be able to sign this MOU, and I hope we will soon have neutrinos interacting in detectors and new physics as soon as possible, of course. Thank you very much.
So when I sign this document and I see the flag in front of me, I'm signing for not for my university, but for the country. What makes me feel the responsibility I have conducting that everything will be okay, and then that the people from my country that will participate in this project will do a good job. I never imagined in my life, really, when I started my career, that one day I would be representing my university, my country, in such a wonderful, big, and remarkable project, including all these partnerships, countries around the world. When I look at you, I mean, even though we were born in different places of the globe, we are a team right now. I see the problem with us is that we speak different languages, but we speak the language of science. We speak the language of education. We speak the language of progress. That's what we want for our people. I mean, the people that we represent in this ceremony.
Besides being so important and critical for DUNE LBNF, in today's geopolitical situation, it also shows how science brings us all together, and science always wins, and that's good to see. For Switzerland, this DUNE LBNF aligns very well with values like innovation, high-tech, brain, where we lead also in Switzerland, and so that's a very good fit. And after all, we go for the best things in the world that we like. So it's chocolate, cheese, and neutrinos. And that's what we like, and that's very happy to be here. Thank you, everyone.
Good afternoon, everyone, thank you. It's many moving words, and it's an honor to be able to say a few words myself, both in my role here at Fermilab, but also as a neutrino physicist. And like Mark, having worked on this project even before it was called LBNF DUNE. And so to be at this very pivotal moment in a journey that we've been on for a while and have a while to go is really wonderful. And to be able to share that with all of our partner nations as we're a team, wonderful words. And that is really how we do our best science, by bringing together the expertise and the capabilities from many partner nations to do an incredibly ambitious project that will address some of the most challenging questions in science in front of us. And I feel great hope for our path going forward with all of us working together to do something really incredible. Thank you.
Thank you, Bonnie. Now I'd like to invite the DUNE co-spokespeople to share a few words.
I have to say that just as we heard from Marco, Fermilab has a very special place in my heart. You know, I was 15 years old. I grew up in Egypt. I was 15 years old, and my family was very academic on my father's side. And so my uncle, who was a biology professor, had given me the National Geographic magazine. And I read an article called Worlds Within the Atom. It's 1985, so now you know how old I am. And in that article, it talked about the CERN lab at CERN, and it talked about the Tevatron. And in 1998, after receiving my PhD, I came to the US for my physics degree. I became a postdoc at the Fermilab Tevatron. So for me, it was such, and so this is a very special place for me. And when I got elected as spokesperson in January, I was very surprised. I've been involved since I joined BNL in 2004 in trying as a young staff member working with my supervisor at the time, Milan Diwan, who became the spokesperson of LBNE. Been involved in trying to get a long baseline experiment in the US. And so suddenly, not only did I come here to the US, did I work at the place I had dreamed of working at, and now I am also involved in the next future with this huge particle physics experiment. So I'm living a dream. I don't know how others like to say it. And to see this happen after almost 20 years of being involved in many different stages, from very young staff member now to seeing, you know, excavation is what, 85% complete. We're going to build this. The MOUs are being signed. All these important people from all these countries. It's indescribable for me to see this happen, and the science, and to see the science happening, and it's happening now. We're not waiting until 2028. You know, there is a lot of scientific output that's coming out now, and more and more ideas for the great things that DUNE can do. We are a telescope for supernova. We are a neutrino interferometer. We are, you know, studying matter by scattering high-intensity neutrinos. We're looking for dark matter using a high-intensity proton beam, an unprecedented high-intensity proton beam on a target that's built by RAL. It's amazing the range of science that we're planning to do. Certainly didn't envision that. And it's an amazing project. And I am indescribably fortunate that I'm here today. And I can't find the words. Thank you.
So this is also my dream lab, as I was coming from this place and is just walking back in the past, while walking inside the future. And I must say, today I'm particularly happy, not only for the signature, but also because the RRB was extremely, extremely efficient. And it is becoming what it should be. Thank you very much, everybody. And it will be a lot of fun, I tell you.
On behalf of the laboratory director, I could formally conclude the program of the signing event.